Do you need a better way to keep track of your inventory for your business? Well, if so, you don't want to miss this video because I'm going to be showing you how you can quickly and easily stand up a template inside of Airtable and, beyond that, give people access to the data through a Softr portal. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I'm the owner here at Gap Consulting, and it's our mission to help you get organized and automated with no-code tools. We use no-code because it is so incredibly flexible and easy to deploy. And the cornerstone of no-code is actually leveraging the power of automation. But if you're not using automation to do all those mundane, repetitive tasks for you, then you are not getting the most efficiency out of your time. So you'll want to start off with my training. Check it out at garethpronovost.com/webinar-registration, and it's going to teach you the building blocks of no-code automation, regardless of what tool you're using to build it. But without further ado, let's hop on into my screen here. We are going to get started with Softr, and I am actually going to be building the database in Airtable through accessing it from a Softr template. So let's get started. I'm going to start here in Softr by creating a new application. And if I go in my templates and I search for inventory, you have an inventory management system right here. So let's go ahead and preview this to get a good idea of what it has to offer for us. So a number of different pages that we can scroll through here. We see that we've got some inventory tracking, different items here, manufacturers. If we load up the Airtable database, we can see it includes product inventory, manufacturers, purchase orders, and users. So pretty cool outline right here. If you want to watch the video inside of Softr already created, you can check that out on your own. I'm going to go ahead and start by using the template. I'll select Use Template here. Now I need to connect to Airtable, so I better open up a new window, set up my Airtable, and go into my account settings. Once Airtable is loaded, I'll click in the upper right corner, and I'll go to my account, and here's where you're going to get access to that Airtable API key. Now keep this blurred out. Don't share this information with anybody. It is the secret backdoor code into your Airtable, but go ahead and copy that key. Flip on back into Softr and let's paste it into the place which is asking for the key. Once we have that, it automatically connects up, and now we can copy a base into our Airtable account and build the Softr front end around that template. So let's go ahead and copy the base. This is going to take us to the base itself, and it's going to ask us where we want to share this. So if you have multiple workspaces that you use inside of Airtable, pick the space where you want to keep this particular base and say add base. That will then be added in just a moment. We have to give Airtable a minute to think. And we have the inventory tracking by Softr. So let's take a quick look at the base and get an understanding of what we're working with here. Our first table is product inventory, and this is linked to our manufacturer here. We have an item price, we have different colors that are available, barcodes if you're scanning things, the manufacturer price so we can obviously calculate our margins, also linking to purchase orders, and looks like we have whether or not something is in stock as well. So this is a good starting place for your inventory. You can always add more information to this as you see fit, add additional fields, and of course you can always increase the records as well. Let's flip into our manufacturers now. We have different manufacturers. Obviously these are the manufacturers for which we sell products. So you would overwrite that to make sense for whatever you're selling. Bring in your contact name, where they're located, their email, their phone number, etc. Now flipping into purchase orders. On a purchase order, we're going to see a particular manufacturer and a particular product. And of course, then we're able to look up the manufacturer price, how many of that thing was ordered, a total price, etc. Now, one thing just off the bat that feels like it's a little light here is we could use an extra table here. So if you are in the habit of getting multiple different items on the same purchase order, then you'll need a junction table in this particular case. Now we've talked extensively about junction tables on this channel, so I'll be sure to link to junction table videos if you're curious about that. What you would need to do though is effectively create a place where people could order multiple different items and then also calculate the quantity for each item and roll that information up into one purchase order. But if you're in a scenario like this one, you'll be looking at just one item per PO, at least one product, I should say, and then we're calculating the quantity of that one product. So again, if you sell multiple product or line items within a PO, you'd need a junction table to break that out. Now, our last table here is our users table. And this is going to be the table where we bring in all the different user information that we have for our particular scenario, and these folks will have access to our database. So let's go ahead and actually delete everybody except for the top two just for now. And we'll start off with the fresh top two. Also note that Softr's already baked in roles for folks here. Administrators and employees, I presume, are going to have different permissions inside of the actual Softr app, which is exactly what we want for a scenario like this. Now that we're all set up here and we've taken a look at what our database structure is, let's pop back into Softr and let it know that we've created it. So we can go ahead and create the application here because we've already copied the base to our particular scenario. And in just a moment, this is gonna, in live time, allow Softr to create the front end app that relates to the database that we just copied over. So let's give that just a moment. It does take a little bit of time, as you can see here, but there's a lot of information that Softr's copying over. So I'll go ahead and pause here and reset once things are all set here. After waiting just a bit, we have our app now created in Softr. So let's go ahead and explore it a little bit and see what our users are gonna experience inside of the app. Now, before I jump into it, I want to point out that all of the information here is being pulled from Airtable. So right here, what we're looking at on our home page, presumably, we've got this Watch Series 4, a Microsoft Surface, and a mouse. If we pop back into Airtable, we have our product inventory table. And if we look at any of these items, here's the Microsoft mouse. And I can look at that. That is the image that's being pulled into Softr. Similarly, if I go into that Apple Watch, expand upon that, that's the image that's being shared again in Softr. So this data is live. It's automatically synced to our Airtable base, and the pages are already set up and talking to the right data source, which is an incredible feature given the speed at which all of this comes together. Now, of course, as you make modifications to your Airtable data schema, of course, you're going to need to also make changes to the front end in Softr, but what an amazing place to start from a template. Let's fly back into the Softr app now and take a look at the different pages. We'll click on pages here. On the home page, we see that we're tied and looking to the product inventory. So if we click on that particular block from the home page, this is our Airtable key, and then it's telling us what Airtable base we're already looking at, and also what Airtable table we're looking at. So as I mentioned, the product inventory table. Scrolling down on the left-hand side where we actually have our app, we can then look at this next block. And this block here is looking at purchase orders. So on the home page, we're looking at our inventory as well as purchase orders. And if we scroll down just a little bit more, this block here is going to give us access to the manufacturers. So it's like we have access to pretty much everything in our base. And then lastly, a sign-in page, presumably for anybody who's not already signed into the app. Of course, they could then access this and sign in. Let's look at some other pages and dig around and see what else we have. We have a manufacturer break where we can look specifically at the manufacturers that we're working with. Again, back to pages, we can look at add product. This page is a form where we can simply type in a new product and it will automatically add this to our Airtable structure. So again, the people on our team can add information into the app without having access to Airtable. All they need is a Softr sign-in and they can start adding data to Airtable through this form right here. Let's also look at the add manufacturer. Here we are able to create a new manufacturer, again through a form. So presumably that information would instantly go to the manufacturer table in our Airtable base. Let's look at a couple other pages before moving on. We have our orders page, a product details page, product inventory, and sign up. So let's actually just take this out for a spin. I will publish this app. And once it's published, it takes just a moment, we get a nice confetti thrown on our screen, and now I can actually go to the live page of the app. Now, because I'm not signed in, of course, I don't see anything. And this is one of the greatest things about Softr is that it helps you keep your data secure. You only want people on your team in your different tools. So here I can log in as an admin to see what the admin experience is. I'll copy and paste this admin email address. Password here is 123456, as denoted by the example information that we have here. So I'm signing in as an admin experience here. And when I sign in, let's take a look at what I have. Right off the bat, it's gonna warn me that my password is not secure. Yeah, 123456 isn't that great, but I'll go ahead and skip all of that for now. I can navigate from my header up here at the top. Flipping into orders, here's access to all the different orders I have. So this is just a visual indication. I can't actually do anything with this data. I can also look at the product inventory here. Flipping over to product inventory, that's my product inventory experience. I can filter out by type over here on the side as well as manufacturer. And I can drill into these different pieces a little bit more by clicking onto the specific one and getting a good look at it. So here is the detailed description of this particular item. I can also drill into my manufacturers as we talked about earlier. Again, I can filter by location on the left, scroll over here, and I can also search by name if I just want to look somebody up and I'm not sure where they are, type in the name, and of course, it's going to filter after just a moment and show me just those particular manufacturers. And then, of course, I also have the ability to add manufacturer information. I'm not going to add a manufacturer now, but instead log out of the experience and come back in as the employee to see how their experience differs. So here I am back on the login screen. Let's go ahead and copy paste and get in here as the employee. Of course, Softr is going to warn us again that our password's not all that secure. That's fine. Let's skip past that. The thing you'll notice is that as an employee, I lose the opportunity to add a new manufacturer. So I don't have that option here any longer. So what this is really demonstrating for us is that you can create different experiences inside your Softr app. One experience for your admin users, a different experience for your employees, and you can get as granular as you like with this. So based on the role of the person who's signed in, you can take away permissions or extend new permissions to that type of user, which then changes the whole experience for them. I know we went fast in this video and covered a lot of ground, but if you have any questions, go back and rewatch it or reach out to Softr directly to find out how they would solve these problems. If you haven't already, be sure to subscribe to this channel if you want to stay on top of no-code news like this. And I will see you in the next video.
As always, I hope you found that to be extremely helpful. If you did and you'd like to learn more, swing by our website and see how we can help. We offer a free Airtable crash course that will help you level up in Airtable quickly. And we also have some paid services, including hourly consultations with our experts. We have some online courses and a group coaching program. And for advanced needs, we can build a bespoke solution for you from scratch. So swing on by, and I look forward to connecting with you soon.